Hey everyone, welcome to NACE Round 6. We will be getting into the draft for Game 1 very shortly. I will, as always, I am Alec Mundell. I am the coach for Truman State University League of Legends. So I will be running the draft while we are doing that. So I will be right back. I will let you guys enjoy the draft as we get into it. Thank you guys for your patience. I will be right back. Hello, everyone. Thank you guys for your patience. We are loading in to game one now. As always, we have the 3-minute spectator delay, and then we have a 2-minute extra delay for Nace. So we will be doing that right now. After that, though, we will be getting right into the game. So we have a pretty interesting draft here. For the Truman side, obviously me doing the draft, I have some insights that most people do not. We were expecting the tank top in every game so far this season. The Georgian top laner has played tank. So opting into the Gangplank, this is a common counterpick to answer the Mordekaiser. I say counterpick very loosely because Mordekaiser wins most of his matchups nowadays. He is a very safe, very strong blind pick. The reason you take the Gangplank is because the oranges do cleanse the Mord R. So he can get out of the R very quickly of the Mord, but we will... should be loading into game shortly here. We have about another minute until we'll go to a small break to wait for the Nace delay, and then we will get into game action. Another common counterpick in the jungle for the Olaf into the Sejuani. Olaf obviously being able to cleanse off the Sejuani CC once he hits the level 6. We will see if in this bot side the Kate Blitz matchup can work out. Kai'Sa getting a little bit more scaling. Once you get to that 2 items, feeling pretty okay. Into the Caitlyn can get on top of her with the Void Hunter. However, in the laning phase, the Caitlyn very, very strong. The Blitz, obviously, a classic laning pick. But we are getting into game very shortly here. So we will go to a quick break, and then I will see you guys on the other side. Thank you. And welcome back, everyone. Thank you for your patience. Yes, unfortunately, due to the nature of NACE rules, we are required a 5-minute delay on all of our broadcasts. So the 3 minutes are added by the client. We have to add an extra 2 minutes. But we are now getting into the first game. Truman, deciding to stack up in the bush here, looking for any level one nonsense from the side of Georgian College. Looks like Georgian is not going to take any fights here in this level one. We will see, like I said before, if the Blitz can find some early hooks here, could spell disaster for the early laning phase of Truman. Looks like Truman is not going to find anything here. Mordekaiser is going to walk top. Ward in the Pixel Brush by the Sejuani. And we are going to have a pretty tame start to game one of this best of three. Thank you guys for coming out. Thank you guys for supporting. We appreciate everything. If you guys have not followed, please give us a follow. No sub button yet, sadly. But in the future, looking for those subs as well. Maybe some Twitch Primes. Thank you, guys. Getting into the first game of the night here. Very standard start. Blue start for the Sejuani. Red start for the Olaf. We'll probably see full clears from both junglers. Not much should be happening. Shouldn't look to fight each other early. The Sejuani does lose out on most of the trades. Most of the one-on-ones towards this game. In the top side here, just a little bit of trading back and forth, just CSing across the map so far. And a QN from the Amumu does not find it, but it looks like Cyber Grizzlies are going to get to first. We'll see if Truman respects this. It doesn't look like they're going to. And they're just walking forward, and Amumu is just walking forward here. This could be an easy play. There is the level up for the level two. Knocks him up, the hook in, and this looks like it just might be first blood. The flash forward from the Blitz. The Q does not land, but there's the flash forward from the Caitlyn for the first blood and does not get one traded back. Very close for the side of Truman, but first blood going to the Cyber Grizzlies of Georgian College. Just Truman not respecting the level 2 power spike, not respecting the all-in, and it is an early 500 gold lead for the side of Georgian. Not much going to be missed on the spot side. Sums for both sides blown, all four summoners blown for the side of Georgian College. For the bot side of them, and it looks like we're gonna have a little bit of a gank here, and the flash away, just respecting the chains from the Silas, does get out of that very cleanly, but there is another flash forced by the side of Georgian College. This lane in the top side, Gangplank already completely out of mana. We will see if Truman can take advantage of that at all. Pops the Corrupting Potion, going to get a little bit more of that back. But back to this mid lane, the counter pick, the Talia, a very, very common counter pick into the Silas. Very hard for the Silas to dash forward over the rocks. And we got a little bit of an invade here on the top side. Going to be a 3 buff for the side of Truman. A small win, but a win nonetheless. The red buff of Cyber Grizzly is going to be taken by the Olaf. And here we get another good trade for Grandpa Singed, forcing the Gangplank underneath the turret. But here comes the dash in, but no mana, does not find the chains, and nothing going to happen there. A very, very tame start besides the level 2 shenanigans from the side of the Cyber Grizzlies, but here comes a little gank onto the bot side looking to punish that flashless Amumu, but does not find it. Looks like Truman will move into the river. They do have bot prio, and there's a hook forward, but the Caitlyn trap does not land and could have looked forward, but there is a good trade from the Kai'Sa. And it looks like the Sejuani does end up claiming the bottom Rift Scuttler. Nothing going to happen there. Talia just going to walk back to the mid lane. The gold lead at 5 minutes, a mere 300 gold. The first blood being the big, big difference there. And we'll see if Blitz can find another hook. Here comes the Hex Flash, going to flash into the wave. And there comes the knockup, but Kai'Sa flashes out, gets the empowered Q, the isolated Q, but has to respect the Sejuani. Another flash blown in the bot lane. That is no summoners available to each side besides the Ignites. And here we go. Olaf creeping, looking for something, not going to be able to find anything. The ward does expire, though. They do know he is here, and there's a pullback again of the passive proc, but this might just be a bad trade for Grandpa Cinch. And can the Gangplank look? He's looking, and there's the ghost popped. Another summoner blown. The Mordekaiser are finding some nice early trades, some nice pullbacks, some nice passive procs, but does bite off a little bit more than he gets you, and that topside is punished, forced to use the ghost. And here is the Blitzcrank looking for more hooks. This was what Truman had to be careful of. Not having any summoner, it is very hard to CS comfortably playing against this Amumu. Excuse me, playing against this Blitzcrank. The Caitlyn very strong as well. And here comes another Hex Flash. Just going to push them under the turret. We'll see how many the Kai'Sa can get. Has missed all of them, but there she gets the first one. Gets another one. And this is going to be most of the CS picked up besides the two melees. Kai'Sa still has not backed. Caitlyn, after that first blood, finding the components for the Noon Quiver, but does not find the gold to fully complete it. Here comes level sixes coming through for both sides. There's the barrel, the first strike proc for the Gangplank, finding a little bit of extra damage, but just CSing so far. A slight CS lead in the top lane for the side of Truman. A slight CS lead in the mid lane for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Not much happening in the bottom. Another good little trade there for the Mordekaiser. Trying to find more, but does take the parlay straight to the face. Cyber Grizzlies looking for a reset on this bot side, trying to spend that little bit of gold that they have collected through the CS. The pickaxe and the longsword picked up for the side of Truman. The Noon Quiver and pickaxe picked up for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Going to be slightly ahead, that kill gold being the big difference. We now see a little bit of gold difference starting to creep up just a little bit. 700 gold for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. First blood combined with the Gangplank passive going to be the most of it. Dragon up and has been up for about 3 minutes. Neither team looking for much so far. Ping's going down onto the dragon. It looks like Truman is just going to start this Rift Herald. And it looks like we're just going to get a trade of objectives here, but this might be another kill. Here comes the Gangplank Guard, a great flash away for the Amumu, but isn't going to find anything, or is he going to be able to get away here? It does not look like it. Gives the kill back to the Caitlyn. Might have had an angle there had he walked up towards the Krugs and queued away there. Would have been the only opportunity for him to get out, looking for that vision, getting punished for it. That is going to be a trade of objectives, though, and there is a good dodge on the chains from the Taliyah, but still a very good trade for the Sylas, pushed away, not going to be able to find much, but here comes a good trade for Grandpa Cinched in the top lane, being able to find the proc of the passive, but not much else after that. The Rift Herald picked up here, a very slow dragon for the side of Cyber Grizzlies, but it looks like they will be able to pick this one up eventually. The Olaf was posturing there for a second, but looks like he's just going to step away and take his bot side camps. There goes the dragon down, the mid lane pushed in for the side of Truman, and not much else happening. But here comes the Blitzcrank going in. A Q lands onto the Blitzcrank, though, and there's the hook, and there is going to be a kill for the side of Truman. The Q misses, and this looks like it's going to be a double kill, but can the Caitlyn find one back? She cannot find one back. The Kai'Sa gets to a double kill in the bot lane for Truman. Big plays from the bot side. The Blitz looking for a fight inside of the wave is not able to find the lethal damage on the Kai'Sa. The Q, the Piltover Peacemaker missing for Caitlyn is the big difference in that engage, and that is going to be very, very nice for the bot side. Relieves a little bit of that pressure that they have been dealing with, and now even gold even gold for both sides, 15.3K apiece. But the Herald still in the back pocket of Truman. How are they going to use this? Have about 4 minutes before plates drop. They will probably drop it before then. All plates are up on every single tier one turret for both sides. Not a single plate taken so far. This bot wave is going to slow push out into Truman. Can Olaf find some kind of gank or a little bit of something to keep this now lead for the side of Truman going forward? But here comes the Talia looking for a trade onto the Sylas, finds the dash forward, finds the chains, and there goes the ignite down onto the Sylas, but it's just going to be the ignite spent for nothing. Neither side can find the lethal damage for the solo kill. We will see here, Sylas getting very low, can't find the big rock chip damage onto him. But here comes the blitz and a flash follow, and there is the hook, and there's the chains, and that is a kill for the Sylas. This counter pick not working out so far. A great realm from the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Finds the flash, finds the knockup, finds the follow. But here comes the play on the top side. The Olaf just running right through him, finds the flash, a good sidestep from the gangplank. Not going to be much there. And here comes the play on the bot side. Can he find the hook? A good flash away from the Kai'Sa, but looks like the Amumu R went down there, but looked like nothing happened. Just a kill. After the flash was forced, probably did not need to queue in there, was trying to save his laner, but instead just finds another kill onto this Amumu. 0-3-2 so far, a tough laning phase for the support of Truman State University. And now a pretty tame part of the game, as no objectives are up, but here comes the Rift Herald being dropped, and it looks like they are looking for this gangplank. Does not have flash after the play, but here comes the bot side of the Cyber Grizzlies looking for this roam, and the Sylas is also going to find it too. What can he find? And there is the Blitzcrank coming in, but takes the Sylas into the R, but that is going to be a kill with the barrels for the gangplank. This could just be disaster for the side of Truman, but here comes the fight, and the Olaf R finds the Q, finds another one for the Olaf, a double kill for the Mordekaiser, excuse me. But that will be another kill going over to the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. 4-2-7 so far, a 900 gold lead after the Herald gets the charge off, gets the multiple plates. But with that time, what can the Cyber Grizzlies find? This Sylas is 202. He is very big, has the Mythic done. Same in the bot side. The Gale Force now completed for the Caitlyn. Another good roam from the support of the Cyber Grizzlies, finding another kill, being able to affect this map so far. The Moby is also the boot choice for the Blitzcrank, just looking to get more and more roams off. A small 1k gold lead for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. We will have Dragon coming up in 20 seconds. Will either team decide to contest this? Truman does not need to contest this if they do not want to, but may opt in for the fight, may look for something. The Amumu R is coming up very, very shortly, if it is not up now. The Ragnarok from the side of Truman also coming up very shortly. Ults and flashes for both sides. The Sylas does not have the flash. A scuttle taken on the top side. Looks like Truman does not want to contest this dragon. What will they find here? How are they going to answer the cross map? Are they going to cross map? Looks like the Mordekaiser is walking down. Ping's going down onto this mid lane from the Mordekaiser, but also here comes the Blitzcrank again. What can they find here? A big pullback, a big R from the gangplank, and that is just going to be death for the side of Truman. 1-0 so far, but here comes the Amumu, finds two, a big shutdown for the Olaf, and there's another kill, a great hook coming through for the Amumu. Finds two on the R, and that looks like it might be Dragon going over to the side of Truman. After I thought that the Cyber Grizzlies were going to just turn straight towards that Dragon with the bot lane of Truman roaming up, but instead decide to look for the extended trade, and that is death for them. A 2-for-1 going over to the side of Truman. The jungler alive for Truman is going to be up, able to take this Dragon. A good win for the side of Truman. Ping's going down from the Cyber Grizzlies on to this Rift Herald. They are coming off the map. Three members going towards the top side. The Gangplank, though, looking for the reset, does not have TP. And Truman also wants to find this fight. We may have another engagement here. Caitlyn going towards the bot side. If Kai'Sa walks towards the top off of this, then Truman will have the numbers advantage, will have the 5v4. Ping's going down for the Cyber Grizzlies on to this river. Looks like they are going to face check this, but just going to find the Amumu. And there's the dash in, there's the CC. But what? Here comes the hook. Does not throw it out yet, but here comes Olaf. The Ragnarok popped. The Taliyah coming forward, trying to deal damage. And there's a hook onto the Mordekaiser, but is it going to mean anything? The Amumu does fall in the bot side. The Olaf is going to get killed too with the parlay from the Gangplank, and this is just going to look like it's going to be a crush for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. The extended play, the Gangplank doing work, getting three kills, had the Essence Reaver done. Truman does not find success in that play, could not get the lethal damage onto the Blitzcrank to start it out. The Sylas goes into the R with the Mordekaiser, is not able to find the kill while he is in there. The Olaf not being able to either find the lethal damage onto the Blitz or onto the Sejuani, flashes out, flashes right into the Gangplank with the completed Essence Reaver. This is going to be a big, big gold swing for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. A 4K gold lead now. Turret taken in the top side and the Herald in their back pocket. A big gold swing for their side. Prowler's Claw completed off of that triple kill for the Gangplank is going to be very, very big now. I'm not sure that anyone in this game can fight him. A little bit of break in this game while the objectives try to respawn. 2:42 on the third Drake of the game. Truman has bought themselves a little bit of time if they don't want to fight this, but here comes another engagement in the top side. The Gangplank are going down, but this looks like it's just going to be a kill, but the orange has come through, and can he find the lethal damage? What is he going to look for? The barrel, not going to be able to find the barrel chain, but that is another a good team fighting tool blown from the side of Truman. The Gangplank are not going to be able to use anywhere else on the map for about 2 minutes. A good trade for the Mordekaiser, able to almost find the lethal damage, but the oranges combined with the corrupting potion able to sustain the Gangplank up enough. Truman has options now. Looks like they're going to just push this bot lane in, push the top lane in. A lot of damage from that early Rift Herald charge, have not been able to find the turret to get that gold traded into their pockets, however. Olaf walking in to this bot side river, secures the Scuttle Crab, a small win for Truman. Will Sejuani be able to find anything? Doesn't look like she will. Still has the Herald in her back pocket. How will the Cyber Grizzlies of Georgian College decide to use it? Looks like they are walking towards mid lane, are committing 4 to this play, but Gangplank is leaving. The Hex Flash back into the bush he was just in for the Blitzcrank, the 5-head play. Sejuani not looking to use that Rift Herald yet, but we do have Dragon coming up in a minute. What the Cyber Grizzlies can do is look to drop that Herald as soon as the Dragon is spawning. Give Truman the choice. Do they want to contest it, or do they want to answer the Rift Herald push? More trades coming in the top side. Good trades for the side of Truman. No TP for the Gangplank. TP for the Mordekaiser. What does Truman decide to do? Olaf going into the Spot River, the Cyber Grizzlies taking a reset 30 seconds before the Drake, and they are going to walk Gangplank bot. I think that Truman should just give this dragon. Do not need to fight this. This does not even push the Cyber Grizzlies to Soul Point. But here come the Cyber Grizzlies going to be walking into this river. And are they going to find anything? Misses the Glacial Prison. The Glacial Prison down. And it looks like Truman is going to posture to contest this. I do not like this play from Truman. They just took the turret on the top side, let the Mordekaiser keep pushing, but instead deciding in the flash in place for the Blitzcrank. Here comes the TP coming in from the Mordekaiser. Truman does want this fight. The Q in, the bandage toss, and a four-man R. The Caitlyn taking in to the Death Realm, going to fight a killer, and this is going to be a very big fight for the side of Truman. A huge R from the Amiibo, but Kai'Sa decides to face check the Sylas, and a huge R from the Sylas, but not going to matter. Only able to find one. A huge fight for the side of Truman. And in the middle of all of that, the Talia is the one that secures the dragon. A huge swing for Truman. The damage from the Caitlyn not going to be able to do anything because of the Mordekaiser R. Just finds a kill, the Mordekaiser does, on the Caitlyn when he takes her into that arena. The Amumu R, have to highlight it, a great play from the support of Truman, finding a multi-man play, swung the fight there. The Gangplank not able to get much damage off either. And a small break in this game again, as neither team really in a position to take this Baron. Both teams just continuing to farm, but will the Mordekaiser find anything here? Finds the claw back in. There is the isolated Q, and that is a lot of damage. It's going to force the flash out for the Gangplank. Any time that Gangplank gets hit by that claw, it is going to be a bad time. But the Amumu going to face check the Blitzcrank, not going to matter, just Hex flashes out. Two completed items for this Kai'Sa. She is 403. She is very, very large. Ahead now of her counterpart, down a little bit of CS, but still up in gold. But the items are very even, basically across the board. Two items completed for the Mordekaiser, two items completed for the Gangplank, 1.5 for both of the junglers. The big difference we see so far in this game is in that mid lane. 057 for the Talia, not been able to find success on the counter pick so far. The Sylas sitting at 524, has the Shadow Flame, has the Everfrost done. He is going to deal a lot of damage. Significantly more than the Talia is, but she does come through, does get the Crystal Scepter does get the Seraph's Embrace completed. Now sitting on two items as well. Cyber Grizzlies do not know that they are sitting on a ward here, going to waste a little bit of time. Truman not really looking for a play here. They're just trying to get the deep vision. Setting up, just trying to find a pick here, but Truman is respecting it very well. Not pushing too far, the Amumu shadowing the Talia, knowing that something is up on this top side. And the Cyber Grizzlies have wasted a lot of time here. In the meantime, Truman takes a gold lead. A measly 500, but a gold lead nonetheless, after being down almost 3,000 before that play at the Drake. More pushing, more waves just being pushed out back and forth, ping-ponging the waves until this next Drake comes up. Some small wins on the bot side for Truman as the Mordekaiser is able to walk in and find those jungle camps. Looks like the Cyber Grizzlies are going to find a little bit back here, going to take back over the gold lead by about 500 after taking that turret. The tier one in the mid lane going down for the side of Truman. Dragon, now coming up in 50 seconds, how will both teams set up? Two good wards in the entrance to the bot side river for the side of Truman. Not much deep vision on this bot side, not any at all, actually. Not any vision on this bot side, but the Amumu is not electing to back here. I would have liked to seen him back and take some wards, but now does not have time, not going to be able to place any wards for this bot side play here, this bot side fight. The Mordekaiser are walking in, just trying to find a little bit of vision. Not able to find much. So there's one ward cleared from the side of Truman. But Silas is going to face check here. Going to dash over the wall. And there is the R stopped by the Amumu. And a pullback for the Mordekaiser. The Blitzcrank just forced to flash out. But this looks like it might just be a good fight for Truman. The Glacial Prison does miss, however. Just a 1-0 so far. But Truman is very chunked. Takes the Sejuani into the Death Realm. What can he find? The dash over the wall from the Sejuani. But decides to walk back into the Mordekaiser. Guys, this is going to be a lot of damage. A chunk in the bandage toss misses from the side of Truman, but Sejuani decides to walk back in and gets auto attacked. That is going to be death, but here comes the gangplank. A great play, great bandage toss onto the Caitlyn, but what can Truman find? A 4v2 right now. The bandage toss misses for the Amumu. Just trying to kite them out is the Cyber Grizzlies. They are able to get away. Blast Cone over the wall in the extended trade. It is a 2-for-1, but at what cost for Truman? Can they start this dragon up? It looks like they're going to, but Blitzcrank sitting in the bush looking for this hook, finds the hook, but finds the, just death, finds the kill. I thought that maybe Mordekaiser would be able, oh my goodness, the huge play from the Gangplank, another triple kill. My goodness, the barrel finds the Taliyah, and the mid laner of Truman just dies. Staying a little bit overstay from the side of Truman. Finds the two kills, but are killed on the backside. And this looks like it's just going to be a Baron over to the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Here's the Amumu decides to just early flash the wall. And the Kai'Sa and the Amumu, the ping's going down. But what can they do? They can't do much here. They can't do anything. The Baron is just going to go straight over to the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. The Baron claimed going to be a couple minutes, and here comes the TP from the Mordekaiser. The bandage toss finds the Blitzcrank, and that is going to be a kill for the Kai'Sa. The TP extended, the bandage toss does find home. They are able to get one. That is one Baron buff down. They have four more to go before this Baron power play is over. And Truman looking to push this in. This is a little bit greedy. Let's see if the Cyber Grizzlies can find anything. And here comes the Silas dash in. Has the Amumu Arba, does not find the Everfrost. But here comes the Mordekaiser just wrapping around. And they are looking for this so hard. Why are they looking for this so hard? Do not need to do this. And that is just a kill. Just a kill for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. And what are they able to find here? A good R from the Mordekaiser. The Silas in the one-on-one is not going to be able to find anything, but here comes the play and finds the Amumu R onto one, but not going to matter. The great stopwatch from the side of the Mordekaiser finds another one. The Olaf gets the kill, but the Kai'Sa looking, stepping forward and going to just find a death for her. The Blitzcrank hook kicks, the knock-up hits. What can the Cyber Grizzlies find? It looks like Mordekaiser is just going to be thrown to the wolves, but there is the pullback and almost finds a kill. So close to turning that for the Mordekaiser. Did not have the flash, did not have the ghost to get the little bit of extra range they needed on the play. Overall, not bad for Truman, knocking off the Baron buffs, able to get a shutdown, I believe, on the Silas. I don't know who the shutdown went on to, but the shutdown on the Kai'Sa given over to the other side. Again, not sure who that kill credit went to. Now, the game slowing down just a little bit. The Baron still up for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. The Caitlyn does still have it, but not many, if anyone else on the team has the Baron buff left. 2 minutes and 10 seconds on this Drake. Going to just push either team to soul point. No soul coming through yet for either side. Will the teams look to fight over this, or will they just look to give it over to the other team? The Amumu looking for a little something here is not seen by the Cyber Grizzlies, but doesn't look like he'll be able to find much, or will he? And the Sejuani just face checking the Olaf, but here comes the Amumu still looking for a place, still sitting in this bush. Is he able to find anything? The Mordekaiser looking for the 1v1. There come the chains back on. Misses the Q, misses everything, but here comes the passive anyways. The power of the Mordekaiser, the chains come back in. The passive is still ticking. The Q misses. The stopwatch expended, excuse me. The ghost also expended. See here, if they can find something, the chains do connect, and that looks like it's just going to be a kill for the Gangplank. Picks it up with the R. The Gangplank R is expended, just like the stopwatch. Lots of different things being traded back and forth there, but ultimately the Mordekaiser does die, does not find the solo kill, and we have 50 seconds until this Drake is up. Not sure how long left on the Mordekaiser TP. Cannot tell. Looks like a very, very short time, though. Sight of Truman misses. Oh, the Blitzcrank misses the Q. That could have been huge. That could have been the angle that the Cyber Grizzlies needed. But it does not matter. They are up 6K gold, getting a little bit more 7K. 7K gold lead after that turret does fall. But on this bot side, it is a 4v4. The TP for the Mordekaiser is up. What can Truman find here? Are they going to look for the fight, or are they just going to give it? Looks like they are going to look for the fight here. Mordekaiser, like I said, does have the TP. Flashes up for everyone in the game except the two mid laners. We are going to see a big fight here. The 10-6 GP does have the TP, does have the R coming up very soon. We'll see where he decides to TP. Going to TP early, just TP into this fight, and both top laners TPing early. But here comes the Blitzcrank, finds the pullback, and there's the CC chain, and that is going to be death for the Blitzcrank. What can Truman find here? Finds two with the R, but just leaving the Talia out to dry. But are they? The Amumu are stolen, taken back, and that is going to be a great fight for the side of Truman. They are able to zone off the main damage dealers for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies, but the Gangplank still alive and finds the huge crit. 1580 on the damage. My goodness, this Gangplank is humongous. Has six items. He has six items already. We are 33 minutes into this game. He is sitting on full build, decides to sell the boots early and just index into more damage. 1580 is the barrel damage. But a small win for Truman. Do find the fight eventually. I think it ended as a 3-for-2 for the side of Truman. Does find the dragon as well. Soul point now for them. And still a pretty, pretty big gold lead for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Can they find a way to close out this game? Baron now up. What will the fight look like there? Will Blitz be able to find a hook? Hasn't been able to find many. Has been getting CC locked and just dying. Not able to find any high value targets so far. One Blitz hook is all it takes, though, to make a difference, to turn this game, to close out this game for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. A tier 2 turret in the mid lane falling for the side of Truman. More gold into the pocket of Georgian College. And this Gangplank is very, very large. I've said it again. I can say it time and time again. Quicksilver Sashes are coming through for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. They have one on the Sejuani, one on the Caitlyn. Just looking to cleanse off that Mord R when they do get pulled into it. But Truman now posturing around this Baron. What will they look for here? The TP is expended from the Silas, just TPing into the mid lane, wanting to make sure that he is not missing from this fight. Now, it is the Cyber Grizzly's turn to walk into this top side river, find the vision, and try to force a fight here with Truman. Might be able to just smack them with the pocketbooks, but the biggest pocketbook in the game is on this gangplank. Truman have to find a way to deal with him. And looks like they might find something here if he decides to push one more. Is deciding to push one more. What will Truman find? But does find the ward, the great awareness from the gangplank, staying safe, finding the Amumu with the ward. But here comes the speed up for the side of the Blitz. Looks for the hook in, but gangplank is not here. Gangplank, the R does come down, but this just might be a good fight for the side of Truman. Looking to pick one up early, does not find it. And Caitlyn trying to get a kill, but does not find one, finds one now. It is 1-1 so far in this fight. But what can Truman find? Looking for more plays. The flash forward from the Olaf finds the kill. Grandpa Singe finds it again. But here comes the gangplank. He is huge, but he gets CC locked by the Amumu. Does find it, but that is a huge shutdown for the side of Truman. And he's going to find the Blitzcrank here. Is he going to get the solo kill? He does get the solo kill on to the Kai'Sa. Wow, these fights are so freaking close. 3-for-3 on both sides. Truman coming out a little bit better, in my opinion, gets the huge 1K shutdown on the gangplank. The gangplank not in the start of that fight. Cyber Grizzly's looking for the fight anyways, and it costs them just a little bit of map control. But here comes the hook onto the Blitz. The trap misses, however, and the passive is proc, but this looks like it just might be death anyways. But there's the pullback, and not going to be able to find anything. This is going to be another kill, but finds one back, and there is the triumph heal. Is he going to find more? He finds a double kill. Mordekaiser finds two. What a play from the top laner of Truman. I thought he was dead to rights, but the double claw, the triumph proc, finds the bot lane of the Cyber Grizzlies. A great play from him. And that is going to give Truman a little bit of map control in this bot side. 35 seconds on this Drake coming up very soon. Sole point for the side of Truman. They can give this over if they want to, but looks like they are going to just get some vision down and look for a play, look for a fight here. The gangplank going for the GA. Don't know what he sold to buy that. Don't think he's had that the whole time though. The finished QSS item coming through for the Sejuani. This is going to be a very, very important fight for this game. The Mordekaiser almost finding full build now. Has to walk here. Has the TP. They decide not to expend it though. And here comes the TP down onto the bot side. What can Truman find here? What are they going to look for? And there's the Sejuani taking the dash onto the face of the Mordekaiser, but not going to be able to find anything. Just looks like both teams are going to continue to posture in this bot side. This is going to be a very close fight. A 5K gold lead. The Gangplank R is expended, but not going to get much done. Chunk down. Here comes the Silas dashing in. Looks for the R on the Kai'Sa, but the the GA does save her. And here she comes out of the R, the huge gangplank barrel. But who is winning this fight? I have no clue. There's the chains back and finds the R, but who is he going to find here? The QSS does save him right out, but the Olaf and the Mordekaiser are huge. The huge play from the Mordekaiser. Again, the Olaf finds one. Can he find another? Does find it, and that is a double kill for the Olaf. The 2v4 from the top jungle duo for the side of Truman. The soul is claimed for them as well in the middle of that fight, and here comes the ghost and steps on the trap. So not going to be able to find it. Is he going to miss this trap? He is. And there is, oh no, she shift clicks the blast plan, and that is going to be a little bit of BM and a death, an ace for the side of Truman. What a fight from the top jungle duo of Truman are able to find the dragon as well to secure the soul. We are 40 minutes into this game, and it is still anyone's game. What can Truman find with this advantage back out on the map? Does not find the claw onto the Sejuani. Just going to be another tier 2 turret picked up for the side of Truman. 12-7-13, this raid boss Mordekaiser is huge. How can the Cyber Grizzlies deal with him? He has been a thorn in their side the entire game. The Navori Quick Blades coming through for the Gangplank, but is just going to face check. This Mordekaiser is huge, but misses the mace, but it's not going to matter. Oh my god. Oh my goodness. He deals no damage now with the Mountain Soul. Takes him into the Death Realm and finds the mace. That is going to be a kill for Truman. The solo bolo for the top laner. But what can Cyber Grizzlies find here? Going to find the knockup onto the Amumu, but he just bandage tosses away, does not find a hook, hits the minion wave instead. And now Truman is 4v4 posturing in this mid lane, matching the four from the Cyber Grizzlies. And meantime, the entire time, the Mordekaiser is pushing. Someone has to answer this push. Can Truman look for the cross map? Look for the Baron. They are going towards it right now. Four members committed from the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Looking for it here. What can they find? No Mordekaiser are. But this is going to be death for the Mordekaiser. Not going to be able to find one back, or is he? Not again. Please, not again. No, he just finds the kill, but in the meantime, that is going to be a free Baron picked up for Truman. Cyber Grizzlies have to commit four to the Mordekaiser at this point in the game. That allows Truman to pick up the free Baron. It is now a 900 gold lead after it was 8K just 12 minutes ago. Can Truman find a way to close out this game? How are they going to do it? Looks like they are going to take this Baron buff and just wait until the Elder Dragon is up. The Cyber Grizzlies just looking to push out their waves. Basically full build for everyone in the game at this point. The Guardian Angel coming through from the Kai'Sa looks like that is going to be up for this next Drake fight. The Silas posturing, looking for something here, but not going to be able to find anything. The Mordekaiser is just huge. They have to commit multiple people to it. And here comes the TP on the deep ward. What can Truman find here? Can they find? There's the Q. There is the play onto the Amumu. And they are looking for more. Find it onto the Sejuani. And there is the curse of the said mummy. And there's going to be a kill for the side of Truman. The death realm for the Caitlyn. That is going to be death as well. And the Olaf finds the smite onto the Sejuani. This is just going to be game for Truman. They run it down. Gangplank is looking to end the game his own, looks for the R back on, but it is not going to be enough to stop Truman State University. Mordekaiser does back just in case, but this game is over. Game one, going the way of Truman State University. A big win for them to go up 1-0 on the series. Can they close it out in game two, or will we need all three games tonight? Please stay with us. Thank you for your patience. We appreciate you guys coming out to support. We will have game two starting very shortly. Thank you guys for your patience, for coming out and supporting Truman State University. In their last NACE regular season match of the season, we will be getting into game two very, very shortly, getting into draft. They have side choice for game two, the Cyber Grizzlies of Georgian College will probably opt for the blue side. That is pretty standard, the swap of sides. They are opting to go to the blue side, so we will see Truman State University piloting the red side for this game. We'll get the counter pick in the draft. Cyber Grizzlies do take the first pick, so we will see how the draft adaptions happen here. We will see if the Cyber Grizzlies of Georgian decide to leave up the Mordekaiser again, if Truman opts into the Mordekaiser Gangplank matchup a second time, or if both teams just go ahead and handshake it and say, well, neither of you are playing either of those. The draft link is coming through very shortly, and we are about to get into draft. Once again, I am Alec Mundell. I am the coach for Truman State University League. So we will be going to a quick break for me. You guys get to watch the draft on your own once again. Thank you guys for your patience. And here we go, getting into the second draft. And welcome back. I am back. We are loading in to game number two. This best of three, Truman State University versus the Cyber Grizzlies Ursa of Georgian College. We will see how this game goes. If Truman can close out this series early, send us home with a 2-0 win. We have another spicy draft for the side of Truman, opting to go towards the Trundle this game, looking to, I believe it was banned by Truman last game, opting to take it for themselves into the Malachi. Trundle will be looking for those early pathings, maybe trying to look for some of those invades, take the lethal tempo, and kill that Malachi early. We will see sort of a similar lane as we saw last game in the bot lane, with the Blitz being paired with the Jinx this time instead of the Caitlyn from the Cyber Grizzlies. This lane is going to come down once again to, can Blitz hit those Qs? Can Thresh hit those Qs? Can Kai'Sa get those isolated Qs as well? A lot of Qs to watch in the bot lane. We have a pretty nice little matchup in this mid lane, a very skilled matchup. This is a very common matchup in professional play. Azir into the Akali. A lot of people opting in to the Akali into the Azir matchup, just trying to make sure they can survive the laning phase and have that kill pressure. Come level 6 into the side lanes, the Akali does do very well into the Azir. However, in this early game, in this laning phase, if the Azir can play at the length of the soldiers, if they can land those early Qs, that early damage in the form of the Sand Soldiers, can be a pretty free lane to farm, can be a pretty free lane to look for some Roams, look for some Shurima shuffles. This game is going to come down to two players. It is going to come down to the Jinx. It is going to come down to the Akali. These are the two main damage dealers for the side of Ursa. Can Ursa keep the Jinx safe? That is going to be the name of the game. Into this Azir, into this Kai'Sa. We are now loading in to the game. So we will take, once again, a quick 2-minute break while we wait for the spectator delay for Nace. I apologize. I wish that we could just watch the gameplay as it happens. Unfortunately, Nace requires a 5-minute delay on all of our streams. We have 3 minutes already built in to the spectator client of League of Legends, and we will be taking a quick 2-minute break while we wait for the extra 2 minutes. Thank you guys for your patience. Thank you guys for supporting Truman Esports. If you have not already, please hit that follow button. Give us a little bit of a shout out, and we will be right back. Thank you. Welcome back, everybody. We are about to start game two action. Truman State University versus the Ursa Grizzlies of Georgian College. We are going to get to the live scene here, and here we go out onto the rift for game two. Comes Truman, comes the Cyber Grizzlies. Will we see some level one shenanigans this game? We have the Blitz still in the game again. Maybe looking, Truman pings going down, looking to set up their level one. Just wards coming out now. The Trundle is in this bush, though. This could be really bad. And are they going to force the flash? They are. A good sidestep from the Trundle. A great play from him. And we are going to not have much happening. The hook does not land. The Trundle does go for the sidestep. The dancing from the Kai'Sa, absolutely beautiful. Going to have a very standard start here for this game. Have the Maokai starting on the red buff, the Trundle starting on the blue buff. Could see a little bit of early game pathing. We'll see what the Trundle decides to do. Doesn't have a very fast full clear, so usually opts in to the three camp and then can look for a gank, whether that is mid or top. We will see what he opts to do this game. But getting into game two now, we have everything coming through. Maokai just grunting on our screen. Let me turn up the sound effects just a little bit. There we go. That's better. And right back into the game now. Maokai just looking for this early camp, gets the red, and there is the Trundle taking the Gromp as well. The early hooks going down and missing for both sides so far. And we got a little snip snip here. We'll see if Gwyn can get a good play. Does not have the Q, it looks like. Just some early laning here. Truman looks like they aren't going to get the level 2 first. Let's see if they respected this game, though. But here comes the level 2. If they just hit the minion, but they don't hit the minion. But there's a big hook from the Thresh. Still do not have level 2. Finally get it. There it comes. And there's the Thresh just flashing forward. Could be dead if they turn on him, but aren't going to find him. But can they find a hook? Going to be coming up very soon. A good trade. The exhaust coming down from the Thresh, the exhaust and the flash used from the Blitzcrank. Two summoners for one in that bot side play. But here comes the Meganar. What are we going to find? And here comes the Trundle looking for it and forces the flash early, but finds the jump away. Is he going to flash forward? He is not going to follow it. A good gank getting off there. The three camp does elect for it. And here comes the pushing mid looking for the invade on this Maokai. Has both lanes pushed up, but is not going to find anything except just going to find this scuttle crab. This Maokai is looking for this, is posturing. Is he going to try to take this? It looks like he is not. Instead, going to look for the gank mid, but here comes, could be first blood here from, has a snip snip, there's the flash forward, there's the snip snip, and that is first blood going over to the Gwyn. No flash forced there by the Trundle. Great play, but here comes a gank on the mid lane. Are they going to be able to find anything? Tries to flash forward, but does not find anything. And there's the missed hook again. And there's a little flash away there from the Trundle. Does force the flash of him. But unfortunately, the Cyber Grizzlies not on the same page for that gank. The Maokai does not find the flash route. The Blitz does not find the hook. Back to farming for both sides. You can see the Azir just trying to get these waves in, trying to support his jungler as he looks for those invades at a small CS lead to start. In this ranged melee matchup, the snip snip coming through again. Good trades for the Gwyn. The trading pattern is very simple. You want to stack up the passive, and then you want to cut them a million times. Death by a million little cuts. You can see the Azir is out of mana, though. is getting pushed under turret as well. The bot lane of Truman just looking to push the wave in, take this early reset. 31 to 33, going to be a small CS lead in the bot lane for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. 300 gold lead here early for Truman State University, finding the first blood this game after giving up the first blood in game one. Good clean plays, a good gank into a solo bolo kill again for Grandpa Singe. This game deciding to pilot the Gwyn instead of the Mordekaiser. Mordekaiser, of course, banned after that monster performance from him. As we talked about in the drafting phase before the game started, both teams just deciding to handshake ban the Mordekaiser and the Gangplank. Both top laners were very, very successful in putting in just absolutely monster amounts of work on both of those champions. Neither team wants to play against those again, but level 6 is starting to come through for both sides. The Gwyn is very large after finding the early solo kill. Able to complete the ninja habit is going to help out a lot when Gnar is looking for those auto attacks and just zoning him off the wave so hard. Looks forward, the dash forward, finds another Q. And this is just brutal for Gnar. Cannot walk up, could look for the needlework if she wants to go for it. Has all of the passive fully stacked up again, but we are going to the mid lane. Another three-man play. This could just be death this time. The hook comes through, but can he find the Shurima shuffle and finds the pull away instead? Maybe could have found an opportunity for a solo kill had he Shurima shuffled all three into turret range, but instead decides to take the 100%, decides to take the safe play. And this Gnar is not having a great time so far in this laning phase. Saw this much the same way in game one. The Mordekaiser having an early lead. The problem with this matchup is when the Gwyn has kill pressure, and excuse that thought while they're looking for a play here in the bot side, the Thresh looking for the play, but this is just going to be a clean kill, but the hook does miss. Decides to go for the flash out, but it does not matter. Should not have expended the flash for that, but this top lane is going worse and worse for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. This Gnar cannot find anything right now. Cannot walk up into this Gwyn's face. Just looking for as many Q farm, as much Q farm as possible. And here comes the all-in, and this is going to be a kill, but misses the first, and there is the second. Finds the second stack of the needlework, and this is just a masterclass in how to control waves. Meanwhile, on the bot side and jungle of the Cyber Grizzlies are going to find the dragon, but a good play, good awareness from the side of Truman, just looking to trade it for the early Rift Herald. Has the control on the top side. The mid lane is being pushed in now, though. So do not have full control there. This is going very, very well for the top laner of Truman. Once again, the strongest player on the map. 2-0-0, 73 CS, a nearly 40 CS lead for Grandpa Singed. Another game, another CS lead, and more solo kills for him. What will Truman opt to do with this Rift Herald that they have now in their back pocket? Thresh looking for a play mid, but does not find anything except instead. Halo is going to just find another invade, a good steal away on the camp. We'll see if if Maokai decides to invade on his own, but going to be very risky if he does go for that play. Does not have a bot lane to support him. Instead, just going to clear his own camps on the bot side. Probably look for the wolves into the Gromp. Maybe taking a reset here shortly. The Blitz back out onto the map. Going for the Milby Boots again this game. We'll see. He had a very big impact early in the game. Did not find many high-value targets, though, later on as the laning phase ended. We'll see if he can change that this game. The Azir, meanwhile, into the top side, looking to set this Gnar farther and farther behind. He is 30 CS down. The Leeching Seer coming through for the Gwen. This is just bad, bad news. But here comes the Azir looking for something. And here comes the Akali R, the perfect execution. The first proc going, but there she comes, dashing through the Azir, not going to be able to find anything. The knockup, probably not going to be able to find much, but here comes the hook back in. The shuriken lands, and the Trundle dies. Blitz finding more plays, constantly roaming mid. What can Truman find on the cross map? This Jinx is by herself, all by her lonesome, but it doesn't look like Truman can find anything. This Blitz finding more success as he roams around the map. But meanwhile, this top side has gone from bad to worse, and the dash forward does not find anything. And here comes the Maokai, but looking for the turn, does not have that. Now has a fully stacked Conqueror, but this might just be a kill for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. It looks like the CT chain is not going to matter, but the flash out and the dash, and Gwen is out. A slippery escape from the Gwen, going to be able to pick up this wave under the turret with the Gnar going back to mini. A great play coming through for Grandpa Singed again, being able to escape on the dive and going to be able to pick up all of this CS. Going to look for a reset here though. We'll see if they have the Riftmaker done. At some point during this game, it is going to take more than just Maokai and Gnar to kill this Gwen. Does not have the fully completed Rift Maker yet, just has the components. Once the Gwen gets that, the healing will be insane. They will not be able to compete with it unless they bring more members than just the Maokai and the Gnar. If you remember back to game one, much the same happening. The top laner for Truman finding early success against the top laner of the Cyber Grizzlies. But last game, the Cyber Grizzlies top laner was able to find some success, some good plays, picked up two triple kills, was 6-2-5 at one point. And here comes the Rift Herald coming down. Just want to get that charge off, it looks like, before the plates expire in a minute and a half. Did not have a very a great way to use it this game. But the mid laner for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies looking for this play, but can they find anything? And finds the perfect execution. Here comes the Maokai R and going to find two, and there's a huge rocket from downtown going to pick up the shutdown. 2-0-1 for the Jinx. Has the Kraken Slayer completed? Cyber Grizzlies committing four members to that top side to find the play on Truman. They are not able to find much on the back side. Looks like they might be able to pick up a plate. Yep, going to get a plate in the bot lane, but if she sticks around here, could be trouble. The Blitz is walking that way, picks up a second plate though. Looks like she is going to be able to get out, but now the Thresh is in the wrong spot. Does have flash, is looking to flash out, and does get the flash over the wall to survive. But that is going to be a dragon going over to the side of the Cyber Grizzlies and three plates on this top side. This Gnar right back in the game, but there's a good hook from the Thresh and decides to take it over the wall. Half HP, pops the stopwatch, and the Blitz hook misses again. There is the flash, there is the cleanse, but what are we going to find here? The Kai'Sa still walking forward, but looks like nothing is going to happen. Going to get out unless the Blitz can find the hook here. Can they find the hook? They are going to miss, it looks like. And The Cyber Grizzlies just looking to posture for this. Another hook lands, and there's the hook over the wall that is going to be a kill for the Akali, and going to find another one here, going to find the double kill, the perfect execution. First prog goes through, and here comes the push, the Shurima shuffle coming back, but the Maokai R is too much. That is going to be a kill for the Jinx, another kill for the Akali, and a triple kill for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies, the mid laner. Now 4-0-3 on this Akali. I told you before this game started, this was going to come down to the performance of the Jinx, of the Akali. Could they deal enough damage? And they are set up in the perfect position to do so. But here comes the Gwen coming through. Gwen is immune, but she is not. And it looks like she's just going to find a kill on to the Blitzcrank. Finds the solo kill again. 3-1-0. And a small break. During that play, the Cyber Grizzlies were not able to pick up the dragon. Looks like Truman will try to take that for themselves, but no Trundle in the area. Ping's coming down onto it. Truman wants it, and it looks like the Cyber Grizzlies are just going to give this one over to the side of Truman. Decide they do not want to fight. The dragon goes over, secured by the Kai'Sa with the the Jinx are coming through. Just going to find a little bit of chip damage, not much. We have a Hex Tech Soul on the map for this game. We will see. Sees the Trundle. Can he find it? Does find the hook over the wall, and that is going to be a dead Trundle. Another hook for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies, finding another pick, going to be able to secure that Rift Herald on the top side. The dragon secured by Truman, but the Rift Herald going over to them. And that is another great hook from the side of, oh no, another great hook from the Blitz. But the Azir Shurima shuffles them the wrong way, flashes right into the teeth of them. And going to find just death across the rift for the side of Truman State University. What can the Gwen find in this top side? Doesn't look like they'll be able to find much, but does find the needlework for the slow, but is not able to find the solo kill. And here comes the Herald drop down onto the mid lane. Are they going to be able to find a second charge? It looks like they are going to, unless Trundle can do something crazy. And the charge does just barely get off. The Meganar looking to ult the wave just to clear it out. A 4.6k gold lead for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. You know, Truman was here just approximately 30 minutes ago in the same exact spot, down even more gold than this. What can they find? Can they find a way back into this game? The Blitz just doing work on the map so far this game. Truman has not had an answer for it. The Azir just deciding to take the blue buff. Ping's going down. Oh no, don't do it. No, he got it. Oh no. The Blitzcrank steals the blue buff. Tragedy for Truman State University. The hook finds its target. And just some more farming going on in this game. The dash forward from the Gwyn, but there is the Meganar. There's the pushback into the wall. The fully stacked Conqueror dodges out on the Q. What can the Trundle find? Finds the pillar back in, and that is going to be another kill going over to the Gwyn. A great play and a flash forward. The hook finds its target, but the flash, oh no, the flash and the R is not enough. Here comes the Maokai coming in on the Gwyn, is not able to find anything. The Riftmaker fully completed, but it's going to be a trade of turrets. The flash hook from the blitz, playing at that max range, Kakashi 6'9 had to flash it in order to survive. Instead, tries to dodge it on their own. It does not work out. Cyber Grizzlies coming now back out onto the map after their reset. Going to have a lot of options here. I think right now they win just about any fight that they take. Jinx and Akali are both very, very large. We'll see if the Blitz can continue to find very, very good hooks in this game. We'll see if they can continue to find Deep Vision. Looking for it here. Ping's going down. And will Truman be able to find the Blitz here? Does not look like they are able to. Takes the Rift, the Hex Tech Gate out to the other side. More farming going down in this game. Not much happening. The CS discrepancy is biggest in the top lane. A big CS discrepancy coming through in the jungle as well. Objective bounties are starting to come off a less than 4k gold lead for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Looks like, oh, this could be disastrous for Truman. Looking for the cross map while they're on the dragon. Looking for the tier one of the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. But what can they find here? The hook or no hook at all. This is just going to be a kill going over to the Trundle. Looking on to the Jinx. Cannot find it. And that is going to be a kill going down. But finds it. Finds the flash, finds the shutdown on the side of the Cyber Grizzlies, but this looks like it's still going to be a very good play for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Akali, untouched in this fight, finds a triple kill. A pretty decent play, all things considered, for the side of Truman. Pick up a last objective bounty on that mid lane turret. The Gwyn finds the shutdown onto the Jinx with the last proc of the needlework. But in the end, it is a 3-for-2 in favor of Ursa. A 3k gold lead still in their back pockets. How are they going to look to extend this? Can probably not threaten Baron at this point in the game. Just pushing out this mid lane is the Gnar. Looking to transform into that Mega Gnar, and the Deep Vision for the Cyber Grizzly is going to be found out here by the Thresh. Ping's going down onto the Thresh, but they're not able to stop him from clearing that ward. Now on this bot side, the Gwyn just pushing in the wave. Looks like the Cyber Grizzlies are going to look for this. But as always, Gwyn is immune, but uses the dash on the Gromp. And here comes the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. Is Gwyn just going to flash, or is she going to look for this play? And that is just a CT chain. A great play by the Gwyn, but it does not matter. What can Truman get on the other side of the map? It does not look like much. Instead, Gwyn just dies for free. Ping's now going down onto this Baron, looking to just get visioned out on it. Camps now being taken away from the side of Truman. Cyber Grizzlies are just looking to starve them out of all these resources that they possibly can. Pushing on this bot side tier 2 as well. How will Truman respond? Not going to be able to find anything as Gnar pushes in the wave. The wave being pushed in for the mid lane. The turret is taken. Is Blitz going to find a hook here? The Thresh just trying to sidestep it and doesn't find the hook. Instead, finds a minion looking for the hook himself. The death sentence not landing. Very, very strong Jinx in this game right now. Very, very strong. Akali has the stopwatch in her back pocket. We will keep an eye on that and see how she uses it. If she is able to find a successful stopwatch play, stopwatch is one of those luxury items that the Cyber Grizzlies can afford to buy right now. They are so far ahead in this game. The gold lead has extended back to about 4.5K. Going to be about four, effectively four, but two items coming through for the Kai'Sa. This is going to be a big buy for the Jinx. Might be able to buy almost a full item on this back. Finds the BF sword, not going to be able to find anything else though. Thought she would have a little bit more gold than that. All things considered, it is not that big of a deficit in the bot lane for the side of Truman State University. A BF sword down, but all things considered, not the worst for them. And here we go. Two players committed to this bot side. And is Truman going to be able to find this? The Cyber Grizzlies do now know about it, and they are pulling off of this. But the half health... The half-health guard does find a kill. There's the Shurima shuffle. Finds three on it. But here comes the Akali. What can she get done? And there's the stopwatch coming through for the Gwyn. What are they able to find? There is the perfect execution, but it is not going to matter. An ace for the side of Truman is able to find it. And all three carries, all three damage dealers are alive. They are able to find the good fight. Akali did not have TP for that fight. Are they going to be able to find this? But it looks like the Baron is going to solo kill the Azir. Do lose out on that, but are in the end able to secure the Baron. This is Truman's path back into this game. Finding the cross map play, the half health Gnar, TPing in, finding a kill, but then dying very quickly. The Akali arriving late, too late. Do make a difference in that fight. Did find the kill onto the Thresh, but that was it. And now Truman State University out onto this map, just looking to take this Drake, to delay the Drake stacking. And Gwyn is just looking to get pulled over the wall and does get pulled back over it, but does have the dash, and this is just going to be dead. Gwyn is immune, but not immune enough. And we'll see here. One dead for Truman. What can they find? Can they continue their comeback in this game? 18 to 11, a 2K gold lead in the pockets of the Cyber Grizzlies. And you could see in that fight, despite being down gold pretty even, the most gold in the game on this Akali was not in the fight. Any fight that Truman can find without the Akali present is a good one for them. This Kai'Sa is almost dead even with the Jinx, the 5-2-5 Jinx, the 1-3-4 Kai'Sa. They are both on 2.5 items. All things considered, Truman can win fights, especially if they're able to find the shutdown onto the Akali. Big Shurima shuffle, that is the skill to keep your eye on. See if Truman can find any death sentences for their side. But Cyber Grizzlies, obviously, up 2K gold, have ways to close out this game. The Blitz hook at any time can completely flip a game on its head. And here comes the Akali looking for the Shuriken and finds it onto the Thresh. But the Death Sentence lands and the flash out. Not going to be able to find the perfect execution. But here comes the play onto the Jinx. Cannot find anything though. And will the Cyber Grizzlies look for something here? Gwyn is pushing on this spot side. Here comes the Akali. It is a 5v4 for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. But here comes the Gwyn TP in. Gwyn is immune, but does get knocked up nonetheless. But here comes the play. The hook in from the Thresh. The exhaust going down onto the Akali. Cannot find a way into this fight. The Jinx is going to go down here, or is she not going to be able to find lethal damage? But it is a 2-for-0 for the site of Truman State University. Great zoning on the Akali, marking her out. And here comes the Surima shuffle, finding two. The hook lands on to the Nar, and there is the flight onto the Akali. She goes stasis, but it does not matter. But maybe it does. She finds a shutdown, but finds a perfect execution too. Can she find another kill? She does not, but the Ignite goes down. She kills two. Is that going to be enough to stop the push from Truman State University? Akali putting the team on her back, trying to do everything that she can to keep the Cyber Grizzlies in this one, and it is enough to keep Truman State off of their Nexus at the moment. But you just see, when Akali cannot get into these fights, it is just a smash win for the side of Truman State University. If they can continue to find these fights where the Akali cannot deal damage, they can close out this game. Now a 1K gold lead for the side of Truman State University. Two drags to two. We have a slight break in the action as both teams wait for these objectives to come up. A minute 30 on the Dragon, a minute 45 on the Baron, but here comes the Blitz looking for the hook and does find the max range hook. Is this going to be death for the side of the Trundle, but healing a lot and is going to go down eventually, probably. But wait a second, here it comes. Can he get to the lantern? He cannot get to the lantern. So close yet so far. If Gnar would have ulted him the other way, could have gotten out, but smartly ults him away from the lantern. And it is 21-16 in kills, but a 1K gold lead for the side of Truman State University. I've said it once, I've said it 1,000 times. The items are even, and oh my goodness, that is a huge chunk from the Gwyn on to the Akali, and she is just dead to the last stack of the needlework. It does not matter. This Gwyn is taking over this game. The hook goes in, but here comes the Thresh looking for the play. And what are they going to find here? Finds the hook on to the Maokai, but cannot find the follow-up CC. Looking for it, finds the play, and that is going to be one kill, two kills for the side of Truman, and a third going down onto the Jinx. Can he find the fourth? Goes into the stasis and will survive with the Thresh Lantern. Four dead for the side of the Cyber Grizzlies. What can Truman find here? Finds the Killer Instinct in, but cannot find the lethal damage. But that is going to be enough. Can Truman State in this game? 5 seconds on the Akali. The Gnar is up, but I don't think they can do it. Finds the kill, but it's not going to be enough. Truman State University, oh, here comes the perfect execution. But he's going to be able to find it. Finds the kill, but ults the wrong way. The Kai'Sa is going to finish the game, and that is a 2-0 for Truman State University, going a win in their last game of Nace Open, taking down the one seed in the Cyber Grizzlies. What a way to end their regular season. And what a game it was. The 2-0 coming through for Truman State University. Victory for them. That has to feel very, very good. Thank you guys for coming out, for supporting the stream. We will have CLOL action coming up in about 2 months. We will see if either of Truman's teams do end up qualifying for NACE playoffs. If they do, we will have that action brought to you live right here. Thank you guys for supporting. Thank you for coming out, for hitting that follow button, for doing everything you guys do. We love you, and have a safe trip home. Thank you for